So here we are at the beginning of High Plains Drifter. Club. That's club members are out here. Building is back in the fall. So it's still a new trail. During the winter, I was up and down this a few times on the fat bike. We'll see. I think it is only May, so the ground's still not fully dried out. It rained a couple days ago, but so trail's still not hard, still a little soft. That's okay though. It'll get hard. Should be going a little faster, but I guess yes. Right now I figure it's pretty good if I'm putting one foot in front of the other. I'm happy with that. Anyone's watching this, if you have any recommendations on how to help with sore muscles, whether it just be a massager or, you know, anything, yeah, just put it in the comments. I'm interested in figuring out basically, not really calf muscles, more like the upper leg muscles from the knees up on the front of the legs is where my discomfort tends to be. Yeah. Oh yeah, legs. You're awake. Someone out here with a dog. Hey puppies. Hey puppies. Hi. Hi puppies. It's okay, puppies. Thank you. He was good. All right. Love this part of the trail. I remember this was part of the trail I'm kind of proud of. My wife is too, because this is a section where we helped work on and level it out and pack it down. And there's a few parts of the trail we worked. This is the first one when going up that we come to, so. This is the first switchback. You gotta climb up. Whew. So if you're coming down it, there's your last switchback. So for those of you that don't know, this trail, High Plains Drifter, was built as an alternate climbing trail to the Metal Trail. It had features added to it to make it fun for those who like to come down it. And in the winter time with the fat bike that come down it, it's awesome. Just be careful, ice in the corners. This is a dirty switchback for climbing. Let's get some breeze going. There we go. Whew. And now it's time for another treacherous climb. A little slow going, but long. So, one thing I should mention So we just stopped to have a look, see if there's a bee's nest in one of the trees there. Doesn't appear that there is. It's just a lot of bees flying across the ground, little bumbles. So we're good there. If you come up High Plain Drifter, I will let you know that it is a good climb, but also quite often I see deer and turkey tracks on it. Yesterday when I came through, I pushed out a deer. So they're here. Just bike and keep your ears open. You never know what you'll, never know what wildlife you'll see in Millbrook. There are bears in the area, but we don't see them very much at all. So it's one of those. They are around. I have seen signs of scat just off the trail in a couple places, but they're nothing to be alarmed about. Plus, if you're doing a video like this and talking, here we are, top of trench. Oh, lucky I didn't pop a tire there. Took that corner a little too tight. And the tire went up on the rock and I slipped down it. I'm not sure I like the way it snapped down it, but hey. Okay, so. Definitely lighter gear required. I'm not going any speeds or any jumps, just enough to keep me going. Oh. Rock or no rock? Oh, fuck, it won't be rock. Oh, that was sketchy. Like, holy mackerel, is the bike actually shifting on me?